to Carnegie Public Library Storytime today, and today we're going to read two special stories, and they are about our Earth because on Thursday we are celebrating Earth Day. So we want you to remember to take care of our Earth and be kind because it's so important. So with that, and this year's theme for Earth Day is called Restore Our Earth. And so we have to think of the ways we can restore our Earth. First of all, I bet we can pick up lots of trash that's out there, and then we can also plant a tree or maybe start a garden. And also we want to try to turn off the water, especially when we brush our teeth, because we let all that water go down the drain, and that is not a way to take care of our Earth. And remember that we're going to turn the lights off so that we can save electricity. And also to remember to be kind and respect each other. That's going to make our Earth a very special place. So, are we ready for our story? Yes, we are ready. And the very first one Miss Phyllis is going to read today is called On Earth. Ooh, look at that. And when we look at our book, it is written by C. Brian Carross. And if we, I don't know if you can see the picture, but if you do, we have a little boy and a little dog. They are on the land. And this is all the water on our Earth. Do you know that our Earth has almost 70% water? That's a lot of water, not so much land. So let's see, this book's going to tell us a little bit how our Earth works. So are you ready? I'm ready. So here we go. It says, on Earth, we go for a giant ride in space, spinning like a merry-go-round. So it goes round and round. And look, he's old. I think he's a happy little guy. Shows us, it says, the Earth spins on its axis. See this little, these little holes right there? And circles the sun in a great sweep. Ooh. We face the sun, its light and warmth as we live our days. And if you think about that, when the sun shines, oh, it just feels so good. It's so warm, makes the flowers grow. Shadows get long as day rolls into night. And I bet you've watched your shadow sometimes, haven't you? It'd be kind of fun outdoors. At night, we turn away from the sun. Here's that little guy, he's sleeping. See a universe of stars and planets. Well, we dream of what we can do tomorrow. So you're dreaming, what am I going to do tomorrow? Am I going to go fishing tomorrow? Well, we spin, we almost travel in an orbit around the sun. Whew. So by the time we get back to where we started, we're 1 year older. So it starts January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, and December. That's a whole year it takes. Isn't that amazing? We count months as we grow. So here you are, you're starting kind of tiny, and then you keep growing and growing. 12 months, and the year has gone by. A whole year. Wow, look at that. Years go by, day by day. We count them with calendars and candles. So this little guy is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 years old. some of you are 8 years old too. Yeah, and I bet some of you get ready to have a birthday. The Earth tilts. That means it kind of leans to one side on its axis. When we lean toward the sun, we're warmer. When we lean away, we're colder. Think about that as it spins around. Sometimes we have, all right, I think we're going to talk a little bit about the seasons. And remember, the seasons are winter, then we go to spring, then we go to summer, and then we go to autumn. And you know what? Right now we're in spring. So we're going to have lots of flowers and lots of sun. Our seasons change from summer to autumn and winter to spring. When the Earth's top side leans away from the sun, okay, so when it leans away, there is winter above the equator and summer below. So now look, see this has winter and this has, looks like it's fall maybe, summer maybe, and it's all different as it leans. Our Earth is so special. In winter, the days get shorter and the nights get longer. Yeah, they do. Okay? Some nights at 5 o'clock at night it gets dark in the winter, but then by spring, the day gets filled with sunlight. Kind of like it is right now. Looks like they're getting ready to go to school. We spin and we circle, rotate and revolve, but we don't fall off because gravity holds us to the Earth. Ooh, yes. Look, this is right there. Gently, slowly, around and around, we hold out our arms. As we glide through the universe. Oh, our Earth is so special. We fly through space as night becomes day, summer becomes winter, and years go by. Wow, look at that. There is our planet. All the different planets. Isn't that a good story? Again, let's look at the title again. Out on Earth, our very special place that we live on. All right, let's put that away. And remember, you can come to the library and check that book out. So my next book is called All the World. By Liz Garton Scanlon. Okay. This is a special book. It was an honor book, so it's kind of special to read. All the World. Let's see what this one tells us. Because Earth Day is so special. Alright, well, it kind of starts with, it says, rock, stone, petal, sand. Alright, so it looks like our little boy and girl, one has sand, one's collecting some rocks. This is going to be kind of like a poem book, so let's see what happens. Body, shoulder, arm, and hand. That's what they're doing to build a moat. A moat is kind of like a small little river with some water. It says a moat to dig. Looks to me like they might be someplace like where there's a beach, I think. A shell to keep. Oh, as they were digging, they found a shell. Miss Phyllis loves the pictures. all the world is wide and deep. Oh, I hope you can see this nice picture. There's a little truck going around, little city. It's wide and deep. Look at the river, all the rocks. Let's see what's on the next page. Oh my goodness, looks like kind of like a garden. Hive, bee, wings, husk, cob, corn, yum, tomato, blossom, fruit so red. Wow, they have corn, and there's bees, and there's tomatoes. Oh my goodness. All the world's a garden bed. See, that looks to me like there's a farmer's market and they're selling all of their good stuff. Wow, look at all the trees. Oh, and we're going to say tree, trunk, branch, crown. Looks like they're outdoors, climbing up and sitting down. Morning sun becomes noon blue. Oh, they're climbing a tree. All the world is old and new. It looks like the wind is blowing. They're hanging on. Road. Ship, boat, wood, and raft. All these things in our wonderful world as you look through a window. We also see nests, birds, feather, fly. All the world has got its sky. Fall, tip the bucket, spill it all. Looks like they're outdoors in the rain. Better luck another day. All the world goes round this way. Look at all the table, bowl, cup, spoon, hungry tummy, supply suppers soon, butter, flour, big black pot. Looks like they're having a great family dinner. Spreading shadows, setting sun. Crickets, curtains, day is done. A fire takes away the chill. Papas, cousins, kin, piano, harp, and violin. Babies passed from necks to knee. That's a wonderful family. All the world is new. Thank you. right, for today's craft, we are going to plant some seeds, and then hopefully you can take them outdoors and plant a little garden. What you're going to need is you're going to need an egg carton. Doesn't necessarily have to be the foam. It could be the one that's made out of cardboard. But we happen to have this beautiful blue one today. Oh, it almost matches my sweater. Look at that. And then you're going to probably need some help, all right, because you're going to take some eggs. Well, you might need to have mom or dad or somebody help you. And you're going to crack the egg, and then you're going to put the shell, take the egg out, have your nice egg sandwich after you cook it, of course. And then you're going to put these little shells in the, just put that there, and the holders just like that. I'm not going to fill all this up, but this is an idea, okay? All right, so there you go. After you put your eggshells in the carton, you're going to have a little bit of soil. And you probably need to ask your mom, dad, grandma, grandpa, somebody to get you some soil. You can always use some dirt from the ground too, but this has all kinds of good stuff in it to make things grow, okay? And today Miss Phyllis has watermelon seeds and lettuce seeds. You can have any kind of seeds you want, all right? So I'm gonna take my soil, and I'm going to put a little bit first to start. Just take a little spoon, put a little bit, and I'm gonna kind of hurry here. Put a little bit of soil. Oh, this is so fun. You're gonna have fun watching it grow. So put a little bit of soil. Okay, we're working on this little project, okay? I'll put that aside. Then I'm going to do 3 watermelon and 3 lettuce for today. Okay, now the watermelon seeds are kind of big, so I'm gonna put them in the palm of my hand, just like that. And I think you can probably see them, all right? I bet you have seen watermelon seeds, so I'm gonna just take, maybe we better put 2, because we're not too sure if it's going to grow. So I'm gonna put 2 there, put 2 here, I'll just set those aside for a few. Now the lettuce seed, oh my goodness, this lettuce seed is so tiny. So what we're gonna do is after you put a little bit in your palm, you're gonna take your fingers and kind of squeeze it together. And you're gonna put a little bit in that one. Now it doesn't take much, a little bit in that one. Little bit in that one. All gone. Okay, now I get to put some more dirt. Okay, so are we ready? I'm gonna take my soil. We're gonna call it soil. Oh, the earth gives us such good stuff. I'm gonna cover those seeds. Here we go. Cover my seeds up. Cover it up. Might be kind of messy, but it's kind of fun to make a mess, you know? Okay, so I have 3 lettuce and 3 watermelon. Put that back. All right, now my next thing is, of course, now we need to have a little bit of water, right? Because water makes things grow. We don't need a whole lot. So Miss Phyllis has a little bit of water in this little container spray. So I'm just gonna go spray, 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 spray. All right, then I'm gonna take all of this, and I'm gonna put it in a window where it's gonna get some sun, okay? After it gets sun and you take care of it every day, you're gonna start seeing some little tiny, your seeds are gonna grow, you'll have some little kind of stems, all right? And remember to kind of keep it, and then you're gonna take this. After all this happens, you're gonna have a little stem. You're gonna take it outside, okay? And you're gonna put it in the dirt, and then it's gonna grow. We hope to have a big watermelon at the end of summer. lettuce will come out probably a little bit sooner than your watermelon. So that's our craft today. So again, you need a carton. Now, if you don't want to have eggshells, you know what else you can do? Let me just show you really, really quick. You can take your soil and you can probably put it in here. You can do two things. Put it in there. Again, put whatever seed. I'll use the watermelon seeds. It's a little bit easier. Okay, here's two. I'll put it in there. Cover it up. It's important to cover. Okay, there you go. And put my water, just like I did on the other ones. All right, after that, I'll take all this stuff and put it aside. Now, what's going to happen to this one? The seeds are going to grow, and then after you get your plant started, you're going to have to put your finger under here and pop that out, and then put it in the garden, okay? So you can do it two ways, either your eggshells or right into the carton. So that's our craft for today. Alrighty, that's it. So we read two books, we did a craft, and I'm hoping that you'll come by the library and pick up those books to read, and also be ready for our summer reading program. It's on its way. So for today, I'm going to say goodbye. Have a wonderful Earth Day, which is Thursday, and remember to be kind and respectful, not only to yourself, but to your friends, and especially to our Earth. Go pick up some trash, okay? All right.